So chapter 9 is all about transformations and symmetry, some of the neatest stuff in all of geometry. In your notes, put this in your table of contents, introduction to chapter 9. So to start, we have four basic types of transformations. There are translations, rotations, reflections, and dilations. A translation is also called a slide transformation. You're probably familiar with this one. The red object is the pre-image. The blue is the image. In other words, the red is where you start, the blue is where you end up. The arrow is called the translation vector. A vector is an important mathematical idea, and it shows both the direction and the distance of the transformation. Plus, the word vector is really fun to say. Vector. Next, rotations. So a rotation is a turn or a spin. Here we've got the pre-image in the bottom right corner, rotated to that upper left corner. So again, rotations, they rotate the pre-image a fixed number of degrees about some center point. So when you define a rotation, you need that center point, which is that red dot in the bottom left, the amount of rotation, in other words, the degree measure, and then the direction, either clockwise or counterclockwise. Next, reflections, flip transformations or mirror transformations. Here we have a reflection in the lake. There's that nice little mountain, and it creates a nice line of symmetry. Also, here's another reflection, ABDE. The blue is the pre-image reflected into the green, the image. You probably remember reflections from the GeoGebra project. Here we had a reflection of a point in a line, and we'll spend more time talking about coordinates, XY grids, and reflections in a bit. Next, transformations. So a dilation is a stretch or a shrink transformation. A stretch or a shrink requires a center of dilation, kind of a bouncing point, and a scale factor. So here I have CD is shown. In order to stretch with that scale factor, R equals 2, we're just going to double up CD to get CD prime. It's possible to also have a dilation in the other direction, right? Have a scale factor less than 1. That would be a shrink dilation. Here, the rectangle in blue is the pre-image, and the green is the image. Then, we have congruence transformations, right? The translations, rotations, reflections. Those are all congruence transformations because they preserve distances, they preserve lengths. In other words, the pre-image and image are always congruent to each other, whereas dilations are similarity transformations. Right? The pre-image and image don't necessarily have to be congruent, but they are indeed similar. And then you can compose transformations. If you string together two or more transformations, then you create what's called a composite transformation. Here we start at the triangle on the top, we reflect over the horizontal line, and then translate to the right, so the end product is kind of a glide transformation. Next, symmetry. Three basic types of symmetry. First, line symmetry, also known as mirror or reflectional symmetry, sometimes called bilateral symmetry. Here, this butterfly shape is indeed symmetric because if you were to fold it in half, the left side and the right side look the same. This pentagon also has line symmetry, but it has more than just that up-down line of symmetry. It has 5 lines of symmetry. Here's a picture of the, the Blue Angels. Two airplanes flying one on top of the other, kind of nice. Picture of reflection symmetry. Now, another type of symmetry is called rotational symmetry. Rotational symmetry exists when the pre-image and the image, when you rotate the pre-image, the two shapes coincide. And so this picture here is an example of rotational symmetry. That star shape has rotational symmetry because if you rotate 72 degrees, the image and the pre-image look the same. Same thing happens again when you rotate 144 degrees, and so on. And so we say this has This particular shape has five-fold rotational symmetry. The magnitude of rotational symmetry is 72 degrees. 72 degrees means if I rotate 72 degrees, then the image will look the same as the pre-image. You'll probably want to write that down. Magnitude of rotational symmetry is 360 degrees divided by the order of rotation. And then finally, point symmetry. Point symmetry, a point of symmetry is the midpoint of all segments joining pre-image and image points. A way to check for point symmetry is rotate the object 180 degrees. If it looks the same, then it has point symmetry. So here's an example. This kind of six-sided star has point symmetry because if we put a point on, let's put a point on the edge, and we take and reflect that point L, let's move it around a little bit first. So there's a tool in GeoGebra called reflect, where is it? Well, there it is, reflect object about a point. So that is the tool we want. We're going to reflect L through P. It didn't work. Reflect L through point P. And we can see L prime, the image of pre-image L. L prime is stuck to the outside of the object as well. And so that indicates that this object has point symmetry. Here we can show you a segment connecting the two. You can even return on the trace feature and show that the image traces out the pre-image. So you get the idea. This pentagon does not have point symmetry. So if we do the same thing with this pentagon, I'll reflect point H, move it around a bit, reflect point H about point P. Come on. Reflect point H about point P. We see that the image is not coinciding with the pre-image. In fact, if we turn the trace feature on, you'll see that the image is just the sort of the flip, the rotation of 180 degrees, the rotated image of the pre-image. So a pentagon does not have point symmetry. Finally, take a look at this word, decode. All of these letters have horizontal symmetry, right? They've got reflectional symmetry. The word tomato, if you line it up down the middle, has a vertical line of symmetry. What I'd like you to do is I'd like you to find at least, find words at least five letters long that have horizontal and vertical lines of symmetry. Bring those to class tomorrow, and maybe the longest words will win valuable prizes.